give them a bird. He shall first appear reclining upon an old spruce stump. And when they have walked around him 10 times, he will split up into 10 birds. And because he is a firebird, I shall command them to call him and his kind torch birds. Worship this conch shell, leaving me no wiser than before as to the meaning of his messages, which came and went and came and went again.
Thank you. And so the unmolested strode and strode again, until coming upon the king, he stood and stared, and the king spake, "Who are you?"
"I really do not know,"
the unmolested replied. "And yet, methinks, I saw you made," the king said.
"And why do you ask me who I am?"
"I really do not know." And so together they came to where the conversation had begun, and they stared, for both had eyes alike. And at this, the unmolested plucked the king from off his throne, and swinging wide the monarch, flung him into the sea. Now the wizard waked and stretched, and learned what had befallen his kingdom's king. And so the wizard went to the unmolested, and spake to him of his wrongdoings, to which the unmolested replied,
"It seems the thing for you to do, O wizard, is just to try up and hint and nod to my ring, for I am what I am. Unmolested and alone, and very wise. It's you a very fool to stand there gaping while I think."
And the wizard pondered in his mind what to do about this unmolested, until deciding to himself,
"I will cause a thought to come in within his mind. He shall suddenly with great curiosity be overwhelmed, and he'll flee the throne and plunge himself into the sea, to know whatever has befallen him whom he bestows. And as he is about to plunge, lo, the mysteries will take him up, and I shall wade out among the slippery rocks and gather in the first king."
Thank you.